Today is October 17th, 2011. This is a litter of 11 Sheepadoodle puppies. They are 5 weeks old today. They were born on September 12th, 2011. This is Cricket and Yogi's puppies. Cricket is our beautiful AKC party factored standard poodle. We have full pedigree on her. She is the mommy. And Yogi is our AKC registered full pedigree Old English Sheepdog. Sorry about the background music. When the other puppies, I have standard poodles and golden doodles, when they hear my voice, then they decide that they're being cheated of my attention, and I do apologize. But anyway, that's them screaming at me in the background now that they hear my voice. This is little Mr. Stedman, now known as Mowgli. He's a little wet. His siblings had slimed him, to say the least, and I decided to take pity on him and rinse him off a little bit, but you can see he's a little fireball. And anyway, and we got a lot of cheering going on in the background there. Okay, now I'm going to try to introduce everybody one by one. Right now we have 3 open reservations in this litter. We might have a little bit of shuffling going around because we do have a cancellation coming through. Unfortunately, the family who actually had reserved one of our golden doodles and one of our sheepadoodles has run into a housing problem and therein had to cancel their reservation. But right now, I'm just going to introduce you to all 11 of these puppies, hopefully not leaving anyone out. You can see their parents' pictures on our website. It is. Oh, don't pick on him. That's your brother. Yes, don't pick on him. Boy, he gave a fuss back too, didn't he? Anyway, you can see their parents' picture on our website. This is Lawpadoodle Kennel, and of course our website is www.lawpdoodlekennel.com. We are located in Lost Creek, West Virginia, and we welcome you to come and see the puppies if you have an opportunity to do so. As you can hear in the background, we have a little bit of a zoo going on right now, but everybody generally will cooperate when we have visitors. And quickly, because unfortunately my new camera, my new video camera, if I might be able to set the setting, but I haven't taken the time to do so like I've had some, to be able to see how long I am talking and how long the video is, and my max on YouTube is 15 minutes, and I don't feel like trying to figure out how to edit it out. So let's get through them quickly. Our little wet Stedman, now Mowgli. Now, he will actually be going home with the family that is local here that is also adopting Ambrosia right over there. There is our Ambrosia. She's the biggest one in the litter, and he's the smallest one in the litter. So brother and sister are going together, and fortunately for me, they're only going to be here, living here about 30 minutes from here. And as a matter of fact, their new mommy, they've got a whole new family that they're going to, but their new mommy has become a very dear friend and has even come out and helped me groom and bathe puppies, and actually ended up showing up to groom on the day this litter was born. And so we ended up whelping the litter together, and which was kind of cool because they were getting a puppy from this litter, so it was really neat for Diana to be here to help whelp the puppies. Okay, now I am going to use my cheat sheet, because I start to learn the names by heart as I do my videos, but since this is their first video debut, I'm a little bit behind on there. Okay, right here we have, oh, let's see, who's our one-eyed girl? This one, two black eyes, is Florina. Oh, this is Ariane. Actually, she was my pick of the litter because of this. See this little eye? When she was born, it looked like that little eye had the one on that's on, well, it would be on the video on the right. It looked like it had eyeliner on it, and she's so pretty. So anyway, of course, Ariane has already been chosen. So she's been spoken for. She has her family. Ambrosia is here. She's the one that I just introduced you to that will be going home with her brother Stedman, now Mowgli. His name is really the only one that I can remember. Some of these may have been renamed, but for my own sanity and memory, which is lacking these days sometimes in the craziness, I'm just going to keep with the ID names for identifying these puppies within this litter for this video. Okay, this is our girl with the purple collar, and she is the one that is still available, and her name is Philippa. Now, these names are, and I'm hoping I'm pronouncing that correctly, these are actually names of types of apples that I got off the website, and I just thought it was kind of cool considering it's fall and it's apple season that I would name these girls or some of these puppies after apples. I think the boys are named after West Virginia Mountaineer football players. Okay. And this boy right here is Devin. He's one of our black and white boys. He has been spoken for. Once again, our girl Philippa here, you can see her white on her chest and her white on her toes. And I'll get back to you, boy. I'm sorry, Devin. I've cheated you. And she's got her coat is now silvering. The majority of these will silver, of course, because of the Old English Sheepdog. Old English Sheepdog puppies are born black and white, but often will silver as they get older. So most, if not all of these, whether they're predominantly black or whether they are black and white, will probably silver a little bit within their first year or so. Okay, and here's our little Mowgli, our little Stedman. Yeah. All right, now I was getting ready to introduce to you Devin. And of course, he's spoken for. Philippa's available, but Devin is spoken for. And so he's one of our black and white boys. Okay. And this girl right here, Florina, now she's the one that I might get shifted around here. We'll wait and see. But unfortunately, her family is unable to adopt her at this point. But I'm not making her available until we work through our list, our current reservations. But do check back because I do believe we're going to have another opening, which will allow a little bit more flexibility if you've been eyeing our site and seeing our last three puppies. But you can't go wrong with the last three that we have available. Speaking of which, we have Dustin right here. He's our boy with our green collar. He's really kind of cool. You'll see on his new photos that he's got that tannish blend in his legs, which is really, really neat. He's got a little star on his forehead, which I just discovered today. And look at his eyebrows. He's got little brown eyebrows or little tan eyebrows. He's got a white chin. And of course, he's got a lot of white on his chest and under his belly. White toes on the front. Actually, three white toes, and I think the other one is just kind of a tan toe. And very, very pretty little boy. And Dustin is available. Okay, and his brother right behind me right here, this one, Hunter. Okay, he's got a little bit more black on him. But you can see he's silvering also on his legs. And he's got, he likes to play with me. And I have a hard time showing you his chest because all he wants to do is play. Okay, but anyway, there is the white under his chin and under his chest. And he's a little bit darker, not quite as much silvering as his brother, Dustin. And, oh, those poodles. They're fine, trust me. They're just in there wrestling and they're mad at me because I'm not giving them my attention. So they're making their presence known. All right, let's see. Who have we? This is Florina. We've already talked to you. Now, this is Connor. Of course, Connor already has his home. He is also one of our predominantly black puppies. And he's the one with our light blue collar. He's got a little bit of tan on his legs as well, and you can see his markings. But his family wanted more of the predominantly black markings. They do make stunning adults, and like I said, they will silver a little bit too, so they're going to be knockouts, and their coats are to die for. I've got one I'm raising from our very first litter born back in May. She is so beautiful. And of course, the nice thing about our first generation, which is where we're going to stay right now, since both the Old English Sheepdog and the Standard Poodle are non-shedding, allergy-friendly breeds, are fairly consistent from puppy to puppy inside of one litter, which is something that we often struggle with our Labradoodles and Golden Doodles. Okay, this girl over here in the potty box, as you can see, they've already wet their potty box. They're learning quite well. This is how we start them when they're potty training. Come here, little girl. This is our Molly. Now, she has been spoken for. She's our predominantly black. Again, her mommy wanted one with predominantly black markings. And she's got a nice big white chest, white legs, and white feet. Little white star on her forehead and her nose. A little bit touch on her collar as well. And anyway, Molly, like I said, has been spoken for. All right. And we saw Devin. And where's Trey? Oh, no, that's Trey. I think that's Trey. Yes, this is Trey, I believe. Yeah. Okay, this is Trey. Of course, Trey is one of our boys. He is already spoken for. I hope I got Devin and Trey straight. Yeah, Trey. Yes, this is Trey. He's beautifully marked. Yeah, hello, Bubby. Hello, Bubby. And he has been spoken for. I've already introduced to you, there our purple girl right there. She's one that is Philippa. She's available. The boy there with the green collar. That one there is Dustin. He is available. And the one in there playing with Ambrosia. That is Hunter. I mean, excuse me. Yeah. He's Hunter. Yeah, and this one's Dustin. And Hunter is available. He's the one over there playing next to the bed. I should have actually put the green collar on Hunter, but I wasn't thinking at this at the time. So anyway, Hunter is the one with the dark blue collar. He's now playing with, I believe that is his sister Florina. Okay, and so there's Hunter. Right there, purple collar, that's Philippa, and she's available. There is Connor, chasing after his big sister. She's going right over to Mommy's bowl. I do feed them mush, and if you looked in their faces when I showed them on the camera, they're a little dirty on their face. That's because they get their faces and everything into their food. These are very, very good eaters. Okay, here is Devin, because Trey is the boy that is predominantly white, and Devin is the one, he's gonna silver too. You can see it mixed in with his coat. Now he's been spoken for. Okay, and I think I did miss my little, who's that? No, I do apologize. This is Florina. Okay, this is Devin here. He's one-eyed, I'm sorry. Yeah, this is Devin right here. There he is. He's being lazy. It's really kind of hard. I didn't put collars on all of these, hoping that the difference in the markings would help me, but just give me time. Hopefully by the second video, I'll have them all straight. And and this one, of course, is Ariane. Right behind her is Dustin. He's got those beautiful brown legs. And we did update our still shots. Okay, here's Ambrosia, climbing on me right now is our girl that's available, Philippa. Okay, playing over there, the blue collar, that is Hunter, the closest to the camera, and he's playing with Molly. And then right there, I believe, is Florina, chewing on the bed. Okay, and here is Devin, being lazy. You being lazy today, huh? You feeling lazy today? Here's our little guy, Stedman. He's drying off a little bit. Mowgli is his new name. Here is Connor again. Give everybody one last look before I run out of time here. There's Connor. And of course, here is Trey. Okay. All right. So there is, once again, our 5-week-old Sheep-a-Doodle puppies from Yogi and Cricket, Lollpadoodle Kennel. And you can also reach us at 304-745-5878 if you'd like to give us a call. You can email us at lpdk10608@gmail.com or lpdkdoodles08@gmail.com. And we thank you very much for viewing our puppies. This is their first video debut, and may God bless you.